The two prime ministers discussed exchange views on recent global developments, including Afghanistan. They also reaffirmed their commitment towards a free, open, inclusive Indo-Pacific region. Prime Minister specifically thanked Prime Minister Suga for very successfully hosting both the Tokyo Olympics and Paralympics in the midst of a global pandemic. The two Prime Ministers discussed exchange views on recent global developments, including Afghanistan. They also reaffirmed their commitment towards a free, open, inclusive Indo-Pacific region. They agreed to enhance bilateral security and defense cooperation, including in the areas of defense equipment and technologies. They also welcomed increasing economic engagement, including the launch of the Supply Chain Resilience Initiative between India, Japan, and Australia, which has been an ongoing dialogue since last year. There was emphasis on the need to develop bilateral partnerships in manufacturing, in the MSME sector, skill development. Prime Minister Suga informed the Prime Minister that in order to operationalize the specified skilled workers agreement, as you know, we have a mobility agreement which enables Indian professionals to work in Japan for certain periods of time. The Japanese side has decided to initiate skills training and language training in India from early 2022.